Good evening. As we go to air tonight, huge problems again on Sydney's beleaguered rail network. Parts of it are at a standstill, with big delays on the T4 Eastern Suburbs and Illawarra lines. Trains are currently delayed by up to an hour, but the wait is even longer for passengers. Queues at town hall, seen here, are down the platform and up the stairs. Sydney Trains say the line has been plagued with issues today, including a power surge at Walleye Creek and signal repairs at Penshurst. And passengers have been warned to brace for strikes on Wednesday, despite the government today insisting the union has been given what it wants. Let's go live to North Sydney Station and Nine Sophie Walsh. Sophie, what did the government offer?
Well, Pete, yet another amended deed. This is beginning to feel a whole lot like Groundhog Day. Today, they agreed to separate the pay and safety issues, also agreeing to make the changes the union wanted to the intercity fleet. But there's a catch. The offer only stands if the union calls off all future strikes, one of which is planned for this Wednesday. The union says it might not be enough notice, and even if they like the offer at this stage, Wednesday's strike is still going ahead, and it could be a bad one. They're refusing to drive all foreign-made trains, which make up 70% of the fleet. It's left the Transport Minister fuming.
Just take the deed. We've offered it to you. We've given you what you wanted. And unfortunately, this is a deed that's going to come at the cost of schools and hospitals and roads across New South Wales.
He might be frustrated, but I tell you who's more frustrated, the innocent commuters caught up in this tiresome stoush, Pete.
Sophie, thank you.